If you do a lot of driving and like to talk on your phone, well, there's a lot of Bluetooth options out there. However, I got one that stands out from the crowd. Stick around, a gear review is coming your way right now. And the product that we're looking at here today is the Blue Ant Commute. It runs between $50 to $90, and it's a Bluetooth hands-free device that will pair to any smartphone out there. The elegant design is pretty slick. It'll fit into any vehicle and simply clips onto the visor of your vehicle of choice. On the front panel is a three-position button, which is sort of a sense interface. You got the left and the right for your volume control, where you just simply sweep across and it says
volume down
or
volume up.
And then you've got this middle button, which if you flip the switch on the side from off to non-hands-free mode or whatever it's called, well, you have to tap that button before it'll listen for a command. If not, if you have it in true hands-free mode, it's always listening, and all you have to say is, Blue Ant, speak to me. And it'll bring up a command prompt saying, what would you like to do, or whatever. But, you know, it's a great device to have in any vehicle, especially these days, being that you can't hold a cell phone, and the wires, they tend to get in the way, or they just generally don't work well. Now, this device runs $50 to $90, depending on where you shop, but it's got a lot of features that you may want to look into. So let's look into some of these features right now. As I said, true hands-free calling. Now, this will allow you to actually say, call Jim or dial this number or whatever, and it'll actually call them out. When you're receiving calls, it'll actually announce the name of the incoming call, and it'll ask if you want to accept or reject this call. Overall volume is really good, and it's very clear. I've had compliments when talking to people via this device. And the best of all, if you want to use this device as a portable speaker to boost your sort of internal volume, if you don't have a Bluetooth in your car built in, well, this can actually stream any of your voice guidance for maps or music that you play, say from Pandora or anything like that. However, there's different options so you can turn that on or off if you choose or choose not to use these features. It stores up to 2,000 contacts and is fairly fast at doing that. Your initial setup, which we'll go over later, will store them all on the device itself, so you don't have to load this up every time and expect to wait 5 minutes. It's a fast boot up time. The multi-point two-phone contact allows you to connect up to two devices at one time and share this connection. So maybe if you're playing music from one and doing voice guidance from the other, or maybe someone gets a call or whatever, you can choose which phone will answer and connect to it. The A2DP streaming allows you once again to stream your music or GPS. Some of these speaker phones that are just not loud or not clear enough, and so why mess with that? You got 20 hours of talk time on one single charge, and charge maybe 2 to 4 hours depending on which type of current you plug it in, be it the included cable for your phone or a USB port at home. Now, 700 hours is standby time. This simply means that if you have it on a shelf or it's clipped in your visor of the car or vehicle of choice, that it's not gonna die within a week. So it has a great standby time right there. It is compatible with iPhone and Android. Anyone that does support A2DP, you could stream the music over that. However, the iPhone still has the better app for metering your battery life and reading out text messages. Unfortunately, it's not all that great on Android, and it's not all that fantastic on Apple, but hey, that is what it is. So let's get this thing on the table and show you some of the pros and cons, and we'll walk you through a setup to see how you can get started with it. Setting this thing up is quite easy. In fact, it walks you through each step via the voice guidance. So let's start by switching on the Blue Ant Commute. There's a simple switch here, which allows us to go between off the non-voice command and full voice command, so we'll go into that.
Powering up.
And usually it'll say your phone is now connected, hands-free triggering is now on. However, we have to cancel that by hitting the button here at the top.
Canceled.
There we go. So at this point, we can give it some voice commands and guidance or whatever. So let's say, Blue Ant, speak to me.
Say a command.
What can I say?
You can say, am I connected? Pair me. Phone commands. Redial. Call back. Check battery. Update phone book. Or cancel. Say a command.
Pair me.
The hands-free is now in pair mode, ready to connect to your phone. Go to the Bluetooth menu on your phone.
Which we've done here. Android
Turn
Note 2.
Turn on or enable Bluetooth.
This is the Galaxy Note 2. So we're scanning for a device. We've got the Blue Ant Commute here. We'll select that.
Select pair or add new device. select the blue ant hands-free.
Which we've already done there.
Your phone is paired. Attempting to transfer phone book.
So it'll ask if you want to transfer the contacts. The phone will probably bring up a prompt, in which case you will want to say yes.
Also, transferring contacts. Please wait.
So the commute would like to access your contacts, which will allow it to go through and...
transferring contacts. Please wait.
Tell you who is calling, as well as allow you to do a voice calling out, so you can say call home or call whoever on your contact
contacts.
On your contact list, and it'll actually call them. So we'll say yes, okay, I'll agree to that. Also in this menu is the ability to say
contacts. Please wait.
What you want it to do in terms of media. Do you want it to stream media or just call audio or none of the above?
Transferring contacts. Please wait.
So we'll wait for it to transfer the contacts. It takes a little while, depending on the size of your contacts. It may take more or less time. I don't have a huge...
Transferring contacts. Please wait.
It likes to tell you it's doing this. I don't have a huge phone book, but it takes about a minute to do. So we'll wait for that.
Transferring contacts. Please wait.
We'll show you how long this actually takes for a phone book of about maybe 50 to 70 people.
Transferring contacts. Please wait.
And then we'll run through a few more things you can do with the voice dictation on this.
Transferring contacts. Please wait. Transferring contacts. Please wait. Transfer complete. Use your voice to control your Blue Ant. Just say, Blue Ant, speak to me, and wait for the prompt to finish. Then say your command. Your phone is connected.
And there you have it. It was simple as that. And the simple trigger of Blue Ant, speak to me.
Say a command.
We'll bring up this where you could say something along the lines of, what can I say?
You can say, am I connected? Pair me. Phone commands. Redial. Call back. Check battery. Update phone book. Or, cancel. Say a command.
Cancel.
Canceled.
Now, in some cases, I have walked out of the car and I forgot to turn this device off or unpair it. Whereas, if I walked far enough away, it's unlinked. And if I'd gotten back into the car, it doesn't automatically relink all the time. So in that case, you would have to say, am I connected? And it would simply go about reconnecting. So let's do that. Blue Ant, speak to me.
Say a command.
Am I connected?
Your phone is connected.
And there it goes. So the ability to do stuff like this is quite easy. Now what if you wanted to say, do some phone commands? Let's see what we could do with that. Blue Ant, speak to me.
Say a command.
Phone commands. This would bring up the voice dialer on the Samsung.
Call, followed by a name or a number.
This would bring up the Samsung voice dialer, which we can cancel at this point. It also has the ability to stream stuff like audio. Let's bring up some royalty-free music from Kevin MacLeod of Incompetech.com and see what we can't do here. My phone is very happy right now, so this may or may not work. TouchWiz has decided to crash on me. This is great for any product review, right? Alright, so it's not going to load. Unfortunately, we are going to be stuck without having to do such a thing. But you saw how fast and easy it was to set up right there on the spot in real time. It's guiding you through with the voice. It's very clear. I've gotten compliments using this in the car. It blocks out a lot of the road noise. Doesn't echo like some of the cars in systems that I've used. And I find that this is a great product for the price range that it's set at. So shop around, find a good deal, and get yourself a Blue Ant Commute. So there you have it, the Blue Ant Commute. I think it's a great product and I highly recommend it. Between $50 and $90, it really fits the style of any car with its sleek, modern feel, and it just flat out works and works well. I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios. If you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button because we get new content each and every Monday. And if you like this video, let me know by hitting that like button. Questions or comments can be left below. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.